Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us a dua when you suffer a loss in any form. Allahumma ajirni fi musibati wa khluf li khayran minhu aw minha. Oh Allah, grant me ease in this difficulty of mine. Oh Allah, compensate for me with that which is better. Make a compensation. The loss that I have suffered, Ya Allah, grant me something in return that is better than it. And oh Allah, make it easy for me. And this is amazing. It's powerful, my brothers and sisters. If you think about it, we have so much negativity that happens in our lives. We have so much hardship. If you believe and you do good deeds, I swear it's good for you. Do you think Allah does bad to you when you believe and you do good? Never, He won't. We think because of our weakness that it's bad. It's good. You don't give up. That's the secret. Keep doing good and don't ever give up. The day you give up, that's the day you've lost. Listen to the second, and we read this all the time in Surah Al-Kahf, where he happened to kill a person. In fact, that was the eradication of a young person who was very bad. Had he grown older, he would have been the means of destruction for his parents. So the someone who lost the life of his loved one, subhanallah, Allah says we took it away intentionally to save the parents from the headache of the future. Allah, who knows, you lost a child. That child, Allah knew that it's going to go away today, because if it went tomorrow, it was going to be a means of your destruction perhaps. Subhanallah. So if you've lost a loved one, do not despair. Yes, we are sad. We are saddened because of the connection Allah blessed us with. If you've lost a loved one, I promise you, the patience you bear and you trust that Allah has done the best thing that He could have, meaning He took away that person at the ideal time. There was no better time, not one moment before, not one moment after. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَمَّا الْغُلَامُ فَكَانَ أَبَوَاهُ مُؤْمِنَيْنِ فَخَشِينَا أَن يُرْهِقَهُمَا طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا. That ghulam, that young person, the young boy whose life was taken, his parents were pious people. We feared that if he grew older, he would have been a means of distress for those parents. So we decided if we take him away now, two things have happened. We saved him, so he also goes to Jannah. And we saved his parents from the torment so that they lead a content life. And Allah says, فَأَرَدْنَا أَن يُبْدِلَهُمَا رَبُّهُمَا خَيْرًا مِّنْهُ. Allah intended to replace for them some child better than that one which they took away. Subhanallah. If Allah took one thing away from you, rest assured that He's going to replace it with something better. If your business burnt down today, I promise you tomorrow it's going to be far greater than what it was. Allah has a plan. You don't understand it today. The problem with man, he lacks two things: sabr and iman, yaqeen, that conviction, and the patience, the forbearance. This is why, my brothers and sisters, be happy with the decree of Allah. No matter what, we believe wal qadri khayrihi wa sharrihi min Allah ta'ala. Good and bad fate is indeed from Allah. And Allah alone, we are mu'mineen. We surrender to the decree of Allah. May Allah make it easy for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that which is better than what He took away from us.